Hey guys, so today I want to do a quick little comparison here, the Xiaomi Mi 4 versus the iPhone 5. Yeah, let's take a look at it over here. Maybe I should just increase that a little bit. So obviously the Xiaomi Mi 4, I think these devices actually cost around the same right now, depending on where you buy them, but at least they now with the new iPhone 6, the iPhone 5 is going to go down a little bit in price, of course. So it's probably a good idea to sell it right now because we don't have a new iPhone. So you can see here kind of like how they are pretty similar in menus and stuff. A little bit annoying here with a screen that sleeps. Hate that. I had a problem with the LG G3 that the screen just always starts to sleep. But obviously these two phones different in a lot of aspects here. So to start off here, we do have bigger display, of course, on the Xiaomi Mi 4, and that's definitely something that's going to be nice with the iPhone 6, that the iPhone 6 is going to have a 4.7 inch display. So it's almost going to be the same size here as the Xiaomi, and the Xiaomi is 5 inch, so it's even a little bit bigger here. And you can see that it has capacitive touch buttons down here, which is something that the next generation iPhone not gonna have. This one has a real button, of course, a real hardware button, like hard, yeah, which also could be nice. I'm also running iOS 8 here, which is not available for the public at the moment, but it will come now when Apple's gonna have an event on September 9th. We're probably gonna see a full version of iOS 8 be released, which is going to be quite nice, but you can see here the latest iOS version, it is running really, really well here on this iPhone here, which is a dual core iPhone. So a dual core iPhone is still pretty nice overall performance. So that's great. What did I say? And if you buy this one from China, thing is here that this one will come with Chinese language and Chinese App Store, but you can download the regular App Store as well, the Play Store, and you can install majority of games, which is pretty awesome. That's why I made some gameplays of that. But some other key things here that's different is this one is simply 9 millimeters, so it's a little bit thinner in thickness versus this Xiaomi here, which is a little bit fatter, like 8.9 millimeters. 1080p display here versus a 640x1136 display here on the iPhone. But you can really see how they're similar in a lot of things, a lot of aspects. This one has MIUI version 5, I think, and we'll have version 6 here in the future from what I've seen, and it should even more look like iOS. You can even see even like similar to like a control center and the notification area, of course. But some other key aspects here that's different with these two devices, of course, is you get way higher internals on a lot of things on the Mi 4, like 30 megapixel camera versus only 8 megapixel camera on the iPhone. And also even the UI is very similar. I'm not sure though if it takes better picture overall, because Apple is just really good at optimizing, but yeah, it definitely looks quite nice. And the iPhone's not that bad. I mean, it is, you do get some extra quality. You can see when you take pictures, it just looks good. Apple's good at that. Apple's good at making things look cool than these pre-filters. The UI is a little bit just more optimized overall. So that is quite nice, but still, 8 megapixel, 30 megapixel. If you blow up the pictures, it's definitely probably gonna look way better on the Mi 4, but how often do you do that? Apple's A6 processor inside of here, which is performing quite nice. So we can probably do a big comparison here in Geekbench. So you can see here on the 4.2, iOS 8, 2.77 gigabytes, almost 3 gigabytes here versus only 1 gigabyte here. So let's just run this maybe a little bit quick. We can get some scores. Adreno 330 GPU here, quad-core 2.5 GHz, Snapdragon 400. Or is it Snapdragon 4? No, Snapdragon 801. But dual core with 3 GHz on the iPhone with the GPU Exynos, or no, not that one, but the 543 MP3 PowerVR GPU, if I can recall. 1440 milliamps on the iPhone versus twice in the Mi4. So twice, I mean, that's a lot. That you get twice the battery life inside of, or twice the bigger battery, or battery size. Also, what I can say is the camera. This one has an 8 megapixel front-facing camera. That's pretty intense. The iPhone only has an 8 megapixel camera on the back, or on the rear. We're probably gonna see some interesting differences here. So, multi-core score 2062 versus 1276. So you can clearly see that the Mi4 definitely outperforms the iPhone, but both are smooth devices overall. You can also see how they differ a little bit in multitasking. Here in the iPhone, it's in the middle. Here, it's at the bottom. But you have a quick clean up button there to close everything at once, which is also quite nice. But yeah, just a quick little side-by-side look. Both are, of course, very, very good phones still for 2014. This one might feel a little bit more plasticky here, definitely on the back, but it feels very, very premium on the sides and overall very, very premium build. Versus the iPhone, of course, feels a little bit slimmer in the hand. It is a little bit smaller, but still quite nice device. So yeah, quick little side-by-side look.